This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman with Juan Gonzalez as we turn to an excerpt of Avi Lewis and Naomi Klein's documentary, The Take, about workers in Argentina taking over factories abandoned by their owners.
Zanon Ceramics. After 2 years under worker control, it's the granddaddy of this new movement. Today, the factory's in production with 300 workers. Decisions are made in assemblies. One worker, one vote. Everyone gets exactly the same salary.
It wasn't always like this. A couple of years ago, the owner claimed that the plant was no longer profitable, that it had to be shut down. The workers refused to accept that fate. They argued that the company owed so much to the community in debts and public subsidies that it now belonged to everyone. In the Menem years, the Zanon factory had received millions in corporate welfare, and the owner still ran up huge debts. Now that his workers have restarted the machines, he's back.
Are you going to get your factory back?
I'm going to get it back.
How are you going to do it?
The
government will give it back to me. The government will give it back to me.
That means the workers can never rest. They keep a 24-hour guard at the factory, and everyone's equipped with a slingshot in case the police show up.
Their struggle against authority has even won them fans in one of Argentina's biggest rock bands. Their suite is in town, and the band is dedicating its show to the workers of Zanon.
The guys in Zanon did. Fighting against the police.
With just marbles.
Like when we were kids with slingshots. Against real weapons, they took over the factory.
But as we discovered walking down Main Street, Zanon's real weapon is the support of the community.
What do you think of the Zanon plant under worker control?
That it works better than under the former owners. Because at least people are working. The tiles are cheaper. And the future is brighter than it was under the owners. All they did was get subsidies from the state, nothing else, and they kept the money for themselves.
All I know is that the community supports them 100%. Because they're not stealing, they're not killing anyone. On the contrary, they're working to feed their families.
There are many companies that should be in the hands of the workers. But it seems that this is not politically convenient. That's the real problem.
And now that we're in production, Mr. Zanon, you can kiss our asses.
What do you think of this slogan of the workers, which is Zanon es del pueblo? Zanon is of the people.
What can I say? It's not true. It's not of the people. The investment was mine. All the work was mine. I put in everything. It can't be of the people.
You're standing in front of $90 million worth of factory, which you and your compañeros have taken over for your own benefit. Do we have a word for that? It's called stealing.
There's another word.
Hay otra palabra que es expropiación.
The Zanon workers have gathered thousands of signatures supporting their demand for definitive expropriation. They donate tiles to local hospitals and schools.
And Zanon's community building has paid off. Since the workers' takeover, they've fought off 6 separate eviction orders. Each time, thousands of supporters have flocked to the factory, set up defenses, and been ready to put their bodies between the machines and the police. Each time, the judge's trustees have retreated, leaving the factory under worker control. For For now, Zenon really is the property of the people.
An excerpt from the documentary.